989 in your pew Bible. Here's the thing, God's not bound by time, so it's not like something comes later or something comes before. Time is just all in front of God. And every once in a while, God gives us a little peek to help us, to give us patience and to know that it's really going to happen and lets us see into the future. He did the same with Micah here. So Micah's like during the time of Isaiah, so around 700 years before the birth of Jesus. And Micah prophesies where Jesus is going to be born. Matthew, when he writes his gospel, tells this account when the visit of the wise men come and they ask the priest, well, where is it going to happen? And the priests know their scripture, and so they go to Micah and they say, it's going to happen in Bethlehem. And if God did that back then he gives us those glimpses yet today of things that are going to happen later on in the future to let us know that God's really in charge and he's in control amidst all the chaos that's going on. In Micah's time, there was a whole lot of chaos going on in the world because even God's people had fallen away from him. But despite their unfaithfulness, which is a good thing for us to hear, despite our unfaithfulness, God will always remain faithful. So hear all that as I read to you from Micah chapter 5. Micah writes, but you, O Bethlehem Ephrathah, who are too little to be among the clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to be ruler in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient days. Therefore he shall give them up until that time when she who is in labor has given birth. Then the rest of his brothers shall return to the people of Israel. And he shall stand and shepherd his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall dwell secure for now he will be great to the ends of the earth. And he shall be our peace. And this is the word of the Lord. And thanks be to God, we say.